Mama? Mm-hmm. What? Mama?
This is one long extension.
Are they human hair?
Yeah.
Yeah, they should, yeah. Except for
the hair. I'll wipe it off.
Everything?
Yeah.
Yep, now it's done.
Oh, you look fabulous.
Yeah, you need help?
Yeah. You just zip them up?
Yeah.
I love those shoes. All right, they're
comfy.
From steps to
also real. The pots I got from steps.
Yeah. You're not gonna fall down again.
That's fair. Looks so nice to me.
Is this dress?
Yeah.
Beautiful.
It's got a body too, right?
Yeah. Sexy mom. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You and my mom?
Yeah.
Right. Mother and daughter.
It's in September, so
that's
the video
color. Oh,
turn
out!
I don't think we got her looking at me.
Yeah. Got it.
Oh, where's the little bag for these things?
Right here.
Yeah.
Okay.
This
is gonna be garbage. Yeah, I don't think you need it.
Well, this is what my shoes came in.
So oh, okay. Okay.
Go like this.
Yeah, but that's gonna be over the under the shirt.
That's supposed to go on the outside. So when his arm is like there. This, it's supposed to be.
But there's like no room with this button.
Yeah. See?
This is
that one.
What? You just
have to reverse it. Maybe they give you the wrong shirt.
Because it's supposed to be like. Pinched like this,
Cuffling
through there.
Yeah.
Wait until you see
Patterns.
Yeah.
Here.
Anyway.
Yeah.
But,
the photographer's the video. This is just for afterwards, I guess I'm going to get camera on her, but I just have to.
Okay, so I just need you to stand and take a
moment. Sure. Which way? That way? Your hair's moving, so what does that mean?
So right now she's dictating how she wants to look. She knows exactly how she wants to look on her wedding day. How are you feeling, sister?
Good.
A little pregnant, is she? This is my wee baby niece. Due in August.
Get her away.
She's due August 15th.
Oh, it's between mine and Ted's birthday.
Yeah.
Great.
Are you excited to be Mrs. Cassar?
Yeah.
Yeah. Anything else to say, Trisha?
No.
Right. That concludes our little interlude of my sister's current state. She's looking beautiful. And all of you ladies are looking beautiful.
I love that. That's nice.
Yeah, Tara and Tammy. Yeah. Gorgeous.
Oh, God.
Oh! Can I have one of these?
Yeah. I want to get the hair, too. The hair is pretty
awesome. Isn't it hot?
Awesome. It is. That's
look
pretty cool.
Look at this
cool.
One. You're a ham.
Shut up. I'm Trish. I was thinking you want to say anything to us.
Oh, really?
She said she noticed a long time ago.
What is the
look at
the
precision.
What am I looking
at? What am I wearing?
I can see the line.
Where?
What am I wearing?
You're wearing
board shorts,
aren't you?
Yeah, no.
Nope.
I see the top of it around the waist.
I'm not wearing it. What am I wearing?
Literally, it's so boring.
We got both of us with our yellow tone.
Oh my god, I'm gonna fall.
How did you do that?
Thank you.
What else is next? We just.
You still got the pant leg
going.
What?
Bite your bottom lip too.
That's good.
Is it in?
We're the ones here. They're really nice. They're beautiful. Tammy!
can't find your sunglasses either.
They're probably my car.
Katie, this one's yours.
Look.
You haven't seen it yet, have you?
Look.
Here
she
goes.
I think we're at the last one.
No, there's still a few more.
Oh, fuck. Yeah.
Oh, shit. It goes all the way.
If it's not tight, like, it's looking good. It's
just
good.
Yeah. Angry?
Yeah, if it's too tight, she's like,
yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, he's gonna cry for sure, because I can hardly look at it.
Okay, I'm not gonna let tears come on.
Let's just hope this stuff is waterproof.
So nice.
Where's the iPhone charger?
I have one though.
Step we're in.
We're heading over there, right?
Yeah.
And where is
that? Hello!
They'll be diving for it. It's gonna be blood on that bouquet.
Look at me, it's fine.
You can't.
I'm sending out pictures right now. I'm kidding.
Downstairs, make sure that
they're all for the cat.
Oh, I can't find
them. Where's the cat?
Yeah.
This way?
Yep. You with us?
Everything?
Yeah. Okay. Put it in the car or. Mm-hmm. One for Mr. Phone.
No tears, alright?
Doesn't make a difference to me.
It is when he's paying for it.
Yeah. Just stand over it. Walk one foot over the other.
I'm not nervous at all, though. I'm not getting married.
What the fuck are you guys nervous about?
Any colder than me. It's like, because you're any colder than me.
What?
No.
I kept it in there, and they just sat in like that?
Yeah. Cool. I'm in percentage.
So now we got it.
Okay. Go? All right. So happy you're all here. Can't believe you're doing this cast. This is amazing, man. So congratulations.
Congratulations, Adam and Patricia. Wish you a lifetime of health, wealth, and happiness.
Oh, nicely said. Wish my boy the best best day in life with his wife. All the best. Cheers to you, buddy.
Cheers.
I will skip the
yeah. Yeah, taking the big one, Casa. Soon behind you, but here we go.
Cheers.
Cheers.
All the best, dude, and good luck with your new life.
New life here, man.
Yeah, grab it. It's a good idea.
All right, cheers, guys. Yeah, let's go, buddy. Here we go.
Yeah.
All right,
buddy.
Here we go. Final march.
Yeah. You got that, you got himself this way.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
I wouldn't consider it a man.
Oh, man.
That's, well, I better use that
point. Yeah. Oh, number one.
I'm sorry.
I didn't realize I was going to get it. There's going to be a really short break, maybe a half an hour, because this whole hall will open up to the, you know, the reception area. So you can go downstairs, you can have a little walk, have a smoke, have a drink, whatever. And then approximately 4:30, there's going to be wine and beer served with some hors d'oeuvres, and everybody get a chance to get to know each other. And then we'll begin the evening. We good with that?
You look so handsome!
Watch the guy in the middle, I know him.
Where did I sit? Here.
Patricia and Adam, I welcome you here to witness
as they pledge in their vows of marriage. They are thrilled that you are here today to share in their joy of this wonderful moment of their lives. And by your presence, you celebrate with them the love they have discovered in each other and your support of their decision to be married. And I ask at this time, who gives this woman in marriage to this man? Thank you. Do you, the friends and family present, support this marriage, also giving them your love and blessings? If so, please respond with, we do.
We do.
Oh, very good. So I take that's a yes. Yeah. Please be seated. Well, Patricia and Adam, this is the day that you take a giant step forward in courage and commitment to love, to understanding, and to growth. And when a commitment this strong is made between two people, the force of that commitment is like a wave of energy that reaches out and changes the world that we live in. Your love is like a pebble dropped in a still pond, and the ripples go to the shores. And so we are blessed by your decision to commit yourselves as husband and wife. But real love is something beyond the warmth and glow, the excitement and romance of being deeply in love. Real love is caring as much about the other's welfare as it is your own. Real love isn't gazing into one another's eyes, but it is looking outward in the same direction together. Love makes your burdens lighter because you divide them. It makes your joys more intense because you share them. And it makes you stronger so that you can be involved in life in ways that you would dare not risk alone. This is indeed a special day. For not only are we witnessing the union of a man and a woman, but we have come together today to celebrate the joining of two families into one. For all meetings and marriages are ordained to accomplish particular ends and prepare the way for others. And as your families before you have prepared your way, it is right at this time that you should honor the love that you have received. In the language of flowers, a rose is a symbol of love. In the language of spirit, the essence of humankind, it is a symbol of the purity of love, always giving its best to us. Trisha, please take this rose. And Adam, please take this rose. And I ask your moms, well, Adam's mom and Patricia's mom, would you please rise?
With you.
I ask you to receive these roses of love from your children. For moms, these roses are saying thank you for your love, your support, and your guidance. I ask you to watch now as life and love continues its circle anew. And may I say to the four of you, well done. Please be seated. So are you ready? All right. Adam, do you take Patricia to be your lawful wedded wife? Will you laugh with her in joy, grieve with her in sorrow, grow with her in love, and be faithful to her alone?
I will.
And Patricia, do you take Adam to be your lawful wedded husband? Will you laugh with him in joy, grieve with him in sorrow, grow with him in love, and be faithful to him alone?
I do.
Would you please hand your flowers to Tara? And I ask you to join hands and face one another. And Adam, you're going to repeat after me as you take my wife.
I, Adam, take you, Patricia, to be my wife.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
Encourage you.
Encourage you.
And inspire you.
And inspire you.
To laugh with you.
To laugh with you.
Comfort you.
Comfort you.
And grow with you.
And grow with you.
I will help you reach your goals.
I will help you reach your goals.
And be your best friend.
And be your best friend.
These things I give to you today.
These things I give to you today.
And all the days of my life.
And all the days of my life.
And Patricia, please repeat after me. I, Patricia, take you, Adam, to be my husband.
I, Patricia, take you, Adam, to be my husband.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
Encourage you.
Encourage you.
And inspire you.
And inspire you.
I will laugh with you.
I will laugh with you.
Comfort you.
Comfort you.
And grow with you.
And grow with you.
I will help you reach your goals.
I will help you reach your goals.
And be your best friend.
And be your best friend.
These things I give to you today.
These things I give to you today.
And all the days of my life.
And all the days of my life.
Andrew, may I have the rings, please?
Yeah.
Thank you so much. These rings symbolize the unbroken circle of your endless love. By their very shape, they are the symbol of eternity, for they are created without beginning and without end, and they speak of the undying love that shall exist between you. May the luster of your rings grow throughout the years as your love for one another continues to grow and to shine. Place it, Patricia's ring. As you place it upon your finger, repeat after me. Patricia, as I place this ring upon your finger.
Patricia, as I place this ring upon your finger.
Know it to be a symbol.
Know it to be a symbol.
Of my love and fidelity.
Of my love and fidelity.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
All that I have.
All that I have.
All that I am.
All that I am.
And I promise.
And I promise.
To be a good boy. Adam, as I place this ring upon your finger.
Adam, as I place this ring upon your finger.
Know it to be a symbol.
Know it to be a symbol.
Of my love and fidelity.
Of my love and fidelity.
I give you my love.
I give you my love.
My faith.
My faith.
I marry you today.
I marry you today.
With all that I have.
With all that I have.
And all that I am.
And all that I am.
Continue to hold hands. And as you look at one another.
Look at one another.
I ask you to feel all the love and the hope and the trust that is in your hearts at this moment and make a memory. In the days and months and years ahead, if either of you should be tempted to argue about who is right, remember this. Oh, I saw that too. I ask you both to remember this moment and remember always not who is right, but what is right. Now may the love that has brought you together continue to grow and enrich your lives. May your marriage be one of ever-growing depth and meaning. May you always respect the uniqueness of each other. May your communication be clear and honest, and your relationship be one of love and trust. And may every word that you have pledged here today be a living truth in your lives. Well, I am sure that you have kissed each other many times, but today is a special kiss. Today seals your promise to one another. Today's kiss seals your intention, and it seals the vows which you have made. Know that the love that has brought you to this point in time is a bond so strong no power on earth may put it asunder. And it is my happy privilege, by virtue of the powers vested in me, to hereby pronounce you, Adam, and you, Patricia, as husband and wife. Adam, you congratulations to you both. May your lives together be long, full, and joyous. Let us turn now to the signing of the register.
All right. Thank you.
Their vows with a great kiss, and they've made their intentions clear to one another that they're going to live the rest of their lives together in love. And today they have decided, as an outward commitment to their inward commitment to one another, they are going to share sand. Now the purpose of the sand, each of you take your container of sand, please. These containers represent each one of them, and they represent all that they were, all that they are, and all that they shall become. And I ask you now to please gently pour your sand together into the one empty container. And negotiation skills start right here. And carefully and gently, they blend their lives together. And as these grains of sand can no longer be separated, so too their lives are one. The individual containers will no longer exist. See you.
Go, girl.
May your lives together reflect the beauty and the symmetry and the harmony of the sand of this container. Indeed, my pleasure to introduce to you for the very first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Adam and Patricia Kassar.
Yeah. talking.
Everyone lined up over here. We're gonna do boats in the background. Now,
well, he's pulled away.
Getting taller. The sun's gonna be in your eyes, so we gotta make sure we're not squinting. So I'm gonna count it. Yeah. Okay, everybody ready?
And taller.
No squinting, Steve.
Okay, ready?
23, 3, 2, 1.
Ready? 3, 2, 1. Okay, perfect. No, you're number two.
You're number two.
All right. Stay there. One more. You guys are all perfect. So when I say one, we're gonna try to stop squinting, okay? Is the sun in your eyes? All right, guys. 3, 2, 1.
I wasn't smiling.
Oh, you should smile. You got such a pretty smile. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Look at me, big smile. 3, 2, 1.
Slow.
Denise Treacher, and Denise is my sister. John's my brother-in-law. Yeah!
I won't hold that against
him. That looks mighty fine.
Just a joke.
Today.
Bought it? Yep. We're good. They're going to take their seats. Denise had a knee surgery, so she's a little bit lame. And you're going to go that way, or after you're coming this way. You're not sitting at the head table. Then we'd like to welcome in Ray and Ruth Kassar. Then we'd like to have the maid of honor and the best man. Maid of honor is Tara Roberts and Andrew's brother, or Adam's brother, Andrew Kassar. Come on in. We'd like to have it with the room. Krista Hastings, Krista's sister, and Andrew with the bride and groom.
Thank you.
little toast to make to the bride and groom. Here's to a full, long life journey. Fill that journey with love for each other, love for your children, and love for your families. Fill it with laughter. Fill it with friends. A full and happy life you'll have had when it comes to the end. And remember, may all your ups and downs come only in the bedroom. That, at the request of the bride and groom, but what we're going to do is there's cards on everybody's table, and they're up against the white thing, and there's some cards there, and there's a pen there. And if you do want the couple to have a kiss, you've got to write a little bit of word of advice on that card. And stand up and read that advice. It's got to be clean. It's got to be funny. And then what we're going to do is we want them, we're going to collect those cards so they have that as a little keepsake too. Okay? And there's one more little favor I would like to ask of some people if they're into it. Oh, sorry. It's a little bit of scene in. I've got like five cards here. And I want to hand them out, okay?
Oh, to,
you can help me, maybe. And I want to ask people, or some people, who's been married 5 years here? Oh, you know what? I want to give you a card. Pass that over. Who's been married 10 years? Hello? Oh, there you go, dear. Can you pass that card over there? Who's been married 15? Here, maybe I could get it to her.
Yeah, I'll do it.
15
years. Nice. 15. Happy.
Who's been married 25?
Whoa! Whoa! Good one! My mom!
Oh, Catherine. Yeah. Come and get this. Who's been married 30 years and over? Come here. Come here, that girl in the red dress up there. Guess you. So with these special cards, what I want is for you to write down a good advice for being married in those time frames. And I want to collect them, and I want to read them during the night. You're pretty cool with that? Oh, you already did it. Okay. Is that good? Where was I? And I would like to say a little something about Trish and Adam. Don't be too long-winded, but young Trish, I've known young Trish all her life, from baby right until the beautiful bride she is now. And Trish has always been a dear niece to me, always fun, always loving, always supportive, and she's always been supportive to my family and brothers and sisters and her parents, and I love her for that. And Adam, I've known for at least a year and a half, I believe. The first time you were over at my place was a Thanksgiving. I don't know how you took us that, Jay. It should have been good, though. I entertained you. With the music or whatever. But you know what, I'd like to say congratulations to both of you, and thank you for honoring me to be your MC this evening, and I love you both. And you know what, congratulations to both of you. And if I'm, oh, cheers, yeah. Yep, and have a drink, yeah. And if I may, I would like to ask Ray Sar to maybe come up and say a couple of words. Then I'll hand over the mic to you.
Trisha
now.
Yeah.
I would like to thank Trisha's parents, Ann and John, Trisha's sister Krista and brother James. I also want to thank all the wedding party for all the hard work, time, support they have all put in to help make this a great day for Trisha and Ann. Speeches too. I hope you guys are all enjoying this day as much as I am. I'd like to share a little story with you. When Adam was born, I felt that I was the luckiest father of all. Wow. I have a baby boy. Then as time passed by, and there I am at a hockey arena, watching my son play hockey. And of course, I, like every other parent on our hockey team, some of those parents are here with us today. Yeah. Felt their son was the best player on the team and on his way to the NHL, millions of dollars to share with their wonderful parents. It's too bad their coaches and the NHL didn't feel the same way about their playmate. Well, I can't speak for all the other hockey parents, but that didn't matter to me. I was proud to be his father, enjoying every minute I spent in those damn cold hockey leagues, watching them play. I would do it all over again in a heartbeat. I can't describe what I'm feeling here today to be such a fortunate father as I see my son Adam settling down with his lovely bride, Trisha. Trisha, I've known you for a little while now. I really believe my son Adam is a lucky man to have found you. I also know that he knows this too. Page 7. Trisha, thank you for falling in love with Adam and making him the happiest man alive. I wish you and Adam will both have a long and wonderful life together. With all our hearts, we welcome you into our family as our own daughter. Trisha and Adam, I do not really know what to say as you begin your life together as husband and wife. I just want you, the both of you, to know through good times or tough times, we will always be there for the both of you. Last but not least, I have one more important request for Trisha and Adam. Please keep those grandchildren coming. Ruth and I are going to need as many grandkids as we can get to help take our baby. I would like you to please stand. I didn't bring my drink. And join me in a salute to the bride and groom. To Trisha and Adam.